Taking the stage here. This is be like sitting back at your front porch. Everybody's got a, some of them even got their front porch chairs. I love this band. And they're going to do it like the old time way, like when we're sitting around on porches having a good, good time. Let's bring them up. These are the old time jammers.
Hello, folks. How are y'all doing? We're happy to be here. We are the old time jammers. We're a jamming band. We're not really a performance band. We're just come up here to jam for you. Can you hear me okay? I can't hear myself. Hey, Matt. They can't hear me. Hello, hello.
Yeah.
One, two, three. Also, where is security? We need security because we often have people rushing the stage and can be dangerous.
We got them there. They're there.
Okay, good. Okay, well.
We got a sniper team for you. Don't worry.
We meet every Tuesday night. Anybody's welcome to come and join us or watch or bring your instrument. And we're up in Boca Raton right now. And we're going to start off with Angeline the Baker by Stephen Foster, written in 1850. And I believe John Burnett wants to say something about this.
First festival that I went to, first Oldtime festival, they played this song at 7 o'clock in the morning. This is what I woke up to. What a great way to start the day.
Next, we're going to play Red Wing, which you already heard when we were warming up. Red Wing, originally published in 1907, but also made famous by Woody Guthrie and made it into a union song, but this is not political, this is old time. And by the way, why are we playing old time at a bluegrass festival? Well,
because
Uncle Penn did, because bluegrass came from old time, okay? That's where bluegrass came from. So we're the old bluegrass.
Well, bluegrass also came from blues and jazz and many other
Scotland and Ireland.
Yeah.
Johnny likes to correct me, or anybody who's speaking. But he's always right.
You're trying to educate people, aren't you?
Yes. Okay. Red Wing. Thank you. very much. I think I'll, there we go. Thank you very much. Our next tune is called North Carolina Breakdown. I don't have the history about it, but something to do with North Carolina. Oh, here we go. One of the very few songs with no known lyrics, it says right here. Just instrumental. It was written by Fiddlin' Arthur Smith.
Wow. Legendary.
It was performed at the Grand Ole Opry in 1927. Okay. North Carolina Breakdown. By the way, we are live streaming on YouTube. We don't have a lot of people watching because we haven't told very many people. It's more of an experiment on this festival, but we're going to be doing that every festival, every month. So we hope we get a following worldwide. Our next tune is called Girl I Left Behind Me. Popular on both sides of the American Revolution. War. And in the Civil War, and there's nobody knows really where it originated. Okay. like to introduce the band, but just to save time, I won't use any last names or it would take too long. Over there, we have Don and Marianne. They know each other very well. They're from Canada, 46 years together. Or as Paul Harvey used to say, on their way to forever together. And we have Larry here, and I'm Andrew. Johnny, Jennifer, Linda. And Linda and Johnny know each other pretty well. And we have Susan over there and Donna at the end. Thank you. Next tune is called Flop-Eared Mule. Let's just say no more about that.
It's the farmer was behind the mule in the field, plowing the field.
Hello, gals.
Must be.
Classic example of a song growing along with the Americans. It is found in an 1839 volume of dance tunes. Lyrics were added by minstrel musicians who cleverly adapted it to wherever they were playing at that time. So we have Alabama gals, Round Hill gals, Philadelphia gals, and many others. It soon went and began to refer to settlers and pioneer women mostly nicely. That's what it says there. Okay, sorry about that.
Yeah, this was inspired by rabbits.
Inspired by rabbits. Okay, Buffalo Gals. Thank you.
left is the old catfish and the cheese.
We're going to now play Big Coyote.
Nice song. We're going to play fast.
Going to play Nail the Catfish. I am wrong. Correct it again. Okay, we're not going to nail the catfish. We're going to play the 8th of January. That's the name of the tune. But many of you will recognize it as the Battle of New Orleans. That's where that tune came from.
You guys remember Evan Carl? Yeah, well, this was his song. He could play it for like a half an hour.
Thank you.
play whiskey before breakfast, which some people like. I don't even like it after breakfast. It's a Canadian fiddle tune which originated in Manitoba and is a favorite of native dance troupes. It has several other titles and probably goes back to Speed the Plow. The various lyrics are just what you'd expect, the pros and cons of the hair of the dog.
Well, you can probably go back in a jamming area and find some good old corn liquor.
Thank you very much. Our next tune is called Pig Ankle Rag.
What's it start off in?
Written by M.E. Williams in 1905. Popular in Oklahoma in the Ozarks and in the mid-20th century, and also frequently heard on the Grand Ole Opry.
Yeah. I have a country music for country music.
Thank you. Thank you again. That was called Pig Ankle Rag.
Oh, Charlie liked that one. Okay.
Next one we're going to play is Ragtime Annie.
Are we doing the C part? Okay, don't forget, you don't play the C part on the end.
Judging by its name and lack of other hard information about it, emerged from the ragtime era around 1900. Listen to it and picture it coming out of a tiny old piano. It was picked up and recorded by country musicians in the 1920s and since.
Tiny little
what? Ragtime Annie. Is called Sarah Armstrong, and I'm sorry I don't have any notes, I didn't find them here, so we'd love to play it. Sarah Armstrong, it was written for Sarah Armstrong, wasn't it?
It was something that somebody named Sarah Armstrong played so much it ended up getting named for her.
Okay, he played it for her so much it ended up getting named for her. We're now going to do a waltz. Or is it? It's a Ashokan farewell. Cajun fiddle. Not exactly an old time tune, but
Don Rich, Bucko is the Buckaroo.
We let it in anyway. We love it so much. Thank you.
two more.
We're making them up as we go along. We're going to play Cold Frosty Morning.
Are you guys ready for this? Oh, you practice for a half hour? Okay. We're going to do a Cold Frosty Morning for all you people from up north. Welcome to sunny South Florida. Isn't this great? It's awesome.
We doubled up on you there.
You guys didn't tell me this.
One more, okay?
One more, that's it.
We're only allowed one more tune.
Exactly.
What would be our grand finale? Any suggestions?
Yeah, let's right.
You can tune in.
Come
This is Dennis Ryan's polka. And it was played in the movie Titanic as they were sinking.
Well, they weren't sinking.
During the movie. Yeah, they were sinking.
Everybody was dancing, that's why they came down.
Okay, here we go. Dennis Murphy's polka. That's it for us. Hope you enjoyed it.
How about the old time jammers, folks? That's good stuff. And they have an open jam, right? They told you about Tuesday someplace, you said?
Tuesday, 6:30 at the Atrium, A-T-R-I-U-M, Atrium in Boca Raton.
Hey, how about that? You can come and join in. The more the merrier, as you can tell. Old time jammers, give them a big hand, folks. Nothing like starting out on a Saturday morning sweating with good old fiddle music. How about that?